Hi guys, on this channel I wanted not just easy topics or easy material to talk about, but also more hot-button issues. This one's about race. Despite some people wanting to dance around it, race is a major influence in a person's life. As people, part of our identity is hardwired to our race. A person's race closely ties in with his sense of who he or she is, their identity. When people think, "Who am I?" or they're asked to describe themselves, they would think of their gender, their religion or beliefs, their married or single status, and one of the first things they think about is their race. Let's face it, many voted for Obama because of his race, just as many women would have voted for Hillary Clinton because of her gender. The world being a diverse place, I'd always been curious about why there are different races of people in the world and not just one. Not all black or all white or all Latino or all Asian, etc. Now, I see the Bible as a source of truth, heavily edited throughout the years, but a guidebook for life nonetheless, and it's always been perplexing how the Bible only has whispers about certain topics or omits them entirely. For example, there is solid fossil evidence for the existence of dinosaurs, yet the topic seems absent from Scripture. Another question is how and why the different races or colors of people appeared on the earth, although there has been some speculation that the different tribes of Israel represented different ethnic groups. Even in multicultural areas of the world, of which America is one, people choose and prefer the company of their own people, their own color. Black people have in their closest inner circle other black people, same with whites associating mostly with other whites, same with Asians, same with Latinos, etc. As a general rule, this seems to be true, and there is absolutely nothing wrong with this. But it also tells you something about race and about human nature. Obviously, people have always most closely affiliated themselves with other like-minded people, those with whom they feel they have the most in common, and race is extremely influential in this. People from different races carry themselves differently. They present themselves differently. They worship differently. It all shows that race is not just skin color. There is a culture associated with each one, hence the term black culture, white culture, Asian culture, and so on. On one extreme, there are people who believe in complete separation of the races. If you remember when Rodney King said, "Can't we all just get along?" a separatist would say, "No, we can't." The separatists believe our differences are too great. There would be no reconciling them. Diversity makes everybody weaker, so no violence, just separate the races. However, separating the races at this point would be ridiculously tough. There would have to be cordoned off Latino-only areas, white-only areas, black-only areas, and so on. And to implement something like this would require overwhelming popular support, which is non-existent. Not to mention doing it would be considered a huge step backward in human beings' ability to coexist together. On the other extreme, there are those who believe in complete diversity. Those who feel they are 100% colorblind and claim that, except for skin color, everyone is exactly the same. But look around you. Does anyone actually live their life like they truly believe that? Of course, most people have a more realistic view. Their feelings on race fall between these two extremes. As for me, I'm a realist, folks. I don't believe all the world's problems could be solved if indeed we were all colorblind and everybody got together and held hands like a 1970s Coca-Cola commercial. When you think about it, practically every single person is racist in that everybody at least has prejudicial thoughts now and then. Is there a single person anywhere who can honestly say they never ever do? There will always be some degree of resentment, always some degree of clashing and bitterness between groups of people. Race and racism is just one aspect that can divide people. There are many more. Think of the Earth as a huge classroom. The reason for the multiple races being placed here, with our differences, is a test in this classroom. Do people of different races have to become instant best friends in order to pass the test? No. The purpose of it is to find ways to get along with each other, learn patience and tolerance as the master demonstrated, brotherly love and tolerance for those who are different than ourselves. And although the world is fraught with problems, we're passing this one test a bit better now than we were 60 years ago. Why are there different races or colors of people in the world and not just one race?
Because they came into the world that way, you'll say. The five races were created all at the same time, distinct and separate. Direction.
God Almighty had a plan, a purpose for doing this, and there not just being one race. What would his purpose be?
To understand the races is to understand the levels of consciousness. It is to understand that the differences in the establishment that one race might survive, two races might war with one another, three races might come together, two against one, four races would divide themselves equally between two and two. But five races seemed to be the right number, you'll say, where there would not be weakness, nor would there be supremacy. But also to understand that these come to a point of learning how to cooperate and get along with one another. For they come from far or distinct places in the universe. And indeed, this is the classroom. This is the experiment. This is the place where the races have been put together. And the universe watches over them and observes them, as God Almighty watches the development of the soul as it migrates through the different races. Understanding the complete mindset of the race. For if you look to the races, you would see that there are distinct ingrained differences. And whether one would be in India for one life, or whether would be in Africa, Nigeria, another, or one would be in America, or Iceland, Russia, the races themselves break down into smaller segments or groups as their consciousness, let us call it, congregates or becomes a concentrated theme. And if you look at the various nations within the various races, you can see subgroups, you'll say. The intention is they all work together, and out of this comes ultimately a completed person, a human, that has developed all the factions, all the distractions and difficulties to a point where they have overcome all these things, and they have become a divine being. Then they become an avatar, a spiritual being in human form. Then they can return or ascend to the higher dimensions, the Christos, and return to God Almighty's peaceful place, so to speak, the face of God. And when this occurs, then they lose their individuality. They give it up willingly and become part of God. In a simplistic way, the drop returns to the ocean. Upon entering the ocean, the drop becomes not a drop. It gives up its individuality, and it takes on the greater consciousness and becomes the ocean. In a way, this is what is taking place here. The different races, the different groups within the races, the different environment or circumstances or lives spent in various races all prepare the soul for its ultimate return. Its completeness in its experimentation and its understanding and awareness to that point in which it willingly gives up its individuality. In short, it returns from whence it came. For the original sin was the sin of separation. The sin of separation was provoked by an individual consciousness that developed from each soul. And now the reverse of losing that individual desire, that consciousness, and a willingness to become embodied with all that was with God Almighty. It is the completeness, the completion, if you will, of the cycle. The races provide in this dimension, in the world as you know it, the diverse stages, the diverse lessons, the opportunity for the soul to go through these experiences and to experience the extremes within the race, you'll say. A convoluted, extremely complex and extensive method of learning. But after all, the soul wishes to know everything. And for those souls that accomplish this, they are indeed adding to the expansion, the consciousness of God Almighty. And this would be the purpose or reason in God Almighty's infinite wisdom, that this jewel of a planet in this remote aspect of the universe was created. So that throughout eternity, those souls that would have gained from these experiences will not ever again wish to separate. See, more could be said on this, but this would be sufficient, and we should end this, for we are becoming depleted.
Thank you very much.
Indeed.